There's been a lot of discussion lately on the site about networking, and networking is definitely an important skill. But there are different degrees of that, and one skill that is something that you almost need to be born with, but you can actually work on to improve on yourself if it's not something that comes naturally to you, is how to take over a room. One of the great tricks to doing this is actually something I know some people, they do quite well, and I've tried it myself a few times, is showing up last. Now, that doesn't mean show up late. You know, it doesn't mean show up so late that people are kind of a bit annoyed when you finally walk in the room. But watching your time and making sure you might be one of the last people to enter the room is definitely going to command a little bit more attention than the guy that was first to show up at the party. I mean, you want to be mindful of how late you're going to be, but making sure you're not the first one in the room and sat at the table, no one's going to notice that guy. But being the guy that shows up a bit late, that kind of comes in the room and gets everyone's attention, that's enough of a way for you to control the dynamic of the room for just long enough to get everyone's attention. So you're on their radar. Try and look at this one as not to be late, but don't be first. Now, there's a fine line between being inconsiderate and late and just being someone that's showing up last to the meeting, and you want to be mindful that you don't cross that line. And you also want to be mindful of whether it's a boardroom meeting or it's a dinner party. But definitely try and be the guy that makes that late arrival without looking like you're some sort of confused, egocentric individual that doesn't really care about what everyone else is up to. Bottom line is, when you walk into that room as one of the stragglers, people are going to want to know what you're up to, and it's going to get people's attention. Fashion is a great tool to distinguish yourself. If you're walking into a room dressed pretty normally, like everyone else is, and you're wearing the kind of traditional outfit, you're gonna blend in. And blending in is not necessarily a bad thing, but we're talking about how to take over a situation, how to be more of a dominant personality. So fashion is one of the great ways to kind of command that sort of attention. If you walk into a room with an outfit that actually stands out, looks a little bit different than everyone else, you're definitely gonna get some people's attention. Now, you wanna make sure that it's not something outrageous where people are talking about you because you don't look like you know what you're doing. You know, spend some time reading some of the other articles on our sites and find out maybe some fashion tips. But definitely going outside the box and looking like you've got a little bit more of a distinctive style to you is enough to say, take a look over here, I'm not like the average other guy in the room. I'd say for me, one of the most important tools in this operation is trying to take control of the conversation. Now, you don't want to be a conversational bully and you don't want to push your opinions on everyone else, but if you've got a great story or you've got a great way to kind of lead and control the conversation around a table, whether it's at a cocktail party or otherwise, that's definitely a way to kind of command a little bit of the attention from the room. Now, if you seize the conversation, you decide to control the conversation, you want to be mindful that you want to get other people to participate. Don't make it a soliloquy, don't make it a monologue, don't make it all about you. But definitely try and be the one who's kind of in control of it, somewhat of the moderator, and people are definitely going to take notice of that. I think one of the most important takeaways on all these tips is really knowing how to find that balance. There's a fine line between coming into a room and taking it over and being appreciated for it versus being someone that's a bit of a bore or overbearing or too dominant that nobody's really interested in listening to. That part you're going to kind of have to figure out yourself, and that goes into knowing how to read a room and how to network properly. But in terms of owning the room and really commanding attention, these are some great tips on how to do it, but it's up to you to make sure you don't overdo it.